Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Monmouth Park here on Sunday. It is the 26th of July, 2020. Gonna look featured ninth race from Monmouth, but before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKit5 for more selections for race courses around the world, and also join me Tuesday for day one of Glorious Goodwood. I'll have previews and selections for all those races here on YouTube, so check that out. But let's get to the ninth from Monmouth, which is the Jersey Derby, a race very rich in history. It's going for a purse of $100,000, race for three-year-olds here. Field of eight horses heading to the turf course, a distance of ground of 1,700 meters, or the distance of ground of mile 1/16 on the Monmouth turf course. 1,700 meters, mile 16th here in the Jersey Derby. Formerly run at, Garden State Park, and then it got moved to Monmouth in, I want to say, the early 2000s, 2001, 2002, something like that. And then it was on a hiatus for about 5 years, and then they took it back last year. And, I think it's a good race. There hasn't been a lot of stakes races this year for these three-year-old turf horses, and it's gonna be a good race, because you either could go after this to that Saratoga Derby in about 3 weeks, or you could wait about a month for the Virginia Derby from Colonial. So I think this year, this race will have some very good indications of what's going to happen later in those big three-year-old races. But my top selection here, I'm going to go with the number 7 horse, Embolden. I'll go 7-1-3-4 in the Superfecta. 7-1-3-4 Super. Top selection, 7 horse, Embolden. 3-0 colt by the factor. Michael Stedham trains. Jose Ferreira gets the mount. Most recent outing came the 15th of December at Remington, 1 mile in the Springboard Mile. And the horse finished 3rd by a half length. It was a little bit wide that day. He had the lead from a stalking position, but then he hung late. You know, just couldn't get the job done. Coming back to turf where he's proven himself a lot better turf horse. I think he'll really run a good race. 2 back, he ran at Aqueduct on the 9th of November. 6 furlongs in the Atlantic Beach. He finished 2nd by 1 3-quarter lengths, and he really closed up well from a horrible beginning that day. Sat back early, closed up well late, nearly got the Jack and Noah. You know, I thought it was a decent place late. Keep in mind, Jack and Noah ran Friday afternoon at Saratoga in that quick haul and ran an absolutely crap race. And then before the Atlantic Beach, he ran the Futurity at Belmont, 6 furlongs October the 6th. Finished 3rd by 3 3-quarter lengths there. He was very wide that day, but he didn't hit the wall, but he didn't quicken up either. I thought it was an okay race. And then before then, Jamestown at Colonial, 5.5, September the 7th. He won by 3 1/4 lengths there on the front end all throughout. Very good run. And then he broke the main at Colonial before that, going 5.8 on the outer turf course in a main special weight, winning by 10, again, on the front end all throughout. That was a very good run. Turf races have been far superior. A little versatile. Could come from behind or set the pace. 5-1, let's use him. Second likely this winner is the one horse Irish Mias. This 3-0 colt by Sky Mesa. Grand Motion trains most recently in the Transylvania Saratoga at Keeneland, going a mile 16 2 weeks ago. He ran horribly, never getting a good trip, but his two-year-old form wasn't bad. Coming here today at 5-2, we'll use him in the multis, but I still prefer the other one before him. But to recap my selection for the ninth from Monmouth, it's Jersey Derby. Let's take the 7 horse Embolden. Also give kudos to the 1 horse Irish Mias. We'll go 7-1-3-4 in the Superfecta, 7-1 in the multi race. So good luck to all, and please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKit5. Good luck, everybody.